Todd Dennis. I am the choral conducting graduate student here at Binghamton University, and it is my pleasure to welcome you today. I stepped in to conduct chamber choir today for our director, Professor William Culverhouse, and I thank you for enjoying With a Lily in Your Hand by Eric Whitaker. Our next two pieces are selections from this year's chamber choir tour. The singers got a chance to perform these songs side by side with some high schoolers that on Long Island. And they wanted to share, the singers wanted to now share these pieces with you. So we hope you enjoy this evening's performance. Thank you very much.
Thank you. get treated better than Robbie, I guess. Just kidding, love Robbie. Hi, for those of you that don't know me, my name is Megan Burrell. Good evening, and I conduct the treble choir here at Binghamton University. Our program tonight, thank you. Our program tonight centers around empowerment through community. Additionally, we are lifting up voices of exclusively female composers and arrangers in our program tonight. We will begin with Terre Neuve, which means Newfoundland. You will hear lots of text painting as we depict the landscape of Newfoundland, the sun, the red rocks, crackling ice. We will follow with Songbird by Canadian composer Sarah Cortell. The song begins with an empowered songbird who begins the story. They are open to sharing their voice with the world. In community, more songbirds join in through layers of voice parts. Enjoy.
Turn, turn, turn. Our next piece is an arrangement of Shumayela, an isiZulu gospel hymn. This is traditionally sung when welcoming a new pastor into a new church. The congregation welcomes through some playful joking. We had the opportunity to work with the arranger, Dr. Charlotte Botha, as she teaches just around the corner at Hamilton College. Originally from South Africa, she gave us a lot of context for the piece, including the dance moves.
We will follow with Crowded Table, an arrangement of a Brandy Carlile tune. Carlile explained the concept of this song as going out into the world and being an activist, but still being able to come home at the end of the day and be in my family and be with people that do not agree with me so that we can all move a little bit closer to the middle of the road. It will feature Alyssa Judding on fiddle and solos by Abby O'Neill, Amanda Egan, and Kirsten Miller.
Yeah.
Our next piece, Under the Willow, is a Stephen Foster song arranged by Susan LaBarr. We sing about the greatest loss of all when a parent loses a child. Throughout literature and history, the willow tree has been associated with mourning, a symbol of humanity's ability to withstand hardship and loss. Soloists are Solana McKee and Emma Zablonsky.
Wild Embers was written by Melissa Dunphy with text by young poet Nikita Gill. Premiered by a high school choir, the piece was later dedicated to a student of the choir who passed away at age 19, a young spark that was extinguished too early. The epitome of empowerment, this text is meant to be an inspiration to all young people. We will perform Willows and Embers without applause in between.
Thank you.
conclude the treble choir portion of tonight's program with I Am the Wind. This is written by contemporary composer Elaine Hagenberg. She paints the text with swirling legato lines, creative key changes, and orchestral piano accompaniments. The listener and performer gets swept up into the deep love and trust in another person, empowered to be your best self through connection to others.
Before we let you go through to intermission,
I'm going to invite the treble singers and the tenors and basses, some of the tenors and basses from Harpur Chorale and chamber singers to come up on stage to join us for a performance of the fifth movement of Gustav Mahler's Third Symphony. This is to give all of you a sample of what is to come next week. The Binghamton University Symphony Orchestra, in conjunction with the Symphoria Youth Orchestra of Syracuse, are performing Mahler's Third Symphony next Sunday, April 30th at 3 p.m. in Osterhout Concert Theater. We encourage you all to come, but to kind of get you in the mood for it, we're going to perform the fifth movement now, once they're all in place. And I would like to take a moment to first thank Megan for a wonderful treble choral experience. And I would like to invite onto the stage my voice teacher and who I've come to observe as a good friend, Professor Brenda Iglesias Zarco, as the mezzo-soprano soloist.
Thank you. Okay. Nobody move.
Tenors and basses, get your butts on stage right now.
Nobody move.
Who's good at taking this?
Thank you. Thank you.
composed and commissioned for Bath Camerata in 2018 by Will Todd, who is a jazz composer and is known for the jazz mass setting called Mass in Blue. I'm very proud of how hard all of these students worked to bring this piece to life. Our next selection by Marcus Garrett has text from a work by William Henry Davis, which speaks to the need for our souls to sing when weighed down by the struggles of our day-to-day life, so that joy can come from our hearts and from our minds.
Sing out.
Our next two selections speak of our soul's connection to our past and the people who came before us. As well, it speaks to how singing can be a magic way for us to navigate life's challenges. Sometimes it is not happiness that music brings, but release, connection, and change.
Thank you.
Before our final piece, as this is my last choral concert at Binghamton, I have several people that I would like to thank. First, to the Anderson Center staff and house managers, thank you for coordinating all of this, especially Dan, Jim, and Kirsten. To the music department for the program and all who took the time to put that together. And then we especially have to thank Derek Young, our accompanist. I also need to thank all of my teachers, especially my thesis committee and my family for being here. And most importantly, to the students of the choir program that have supported me and helped me grow over the past 2 years. Thank you very much. And finally, for his support, guidance, patience, and continuous encouragement, Bill, I am forever grateful for all you have done for me over the past 2 years and for taking a chance on me in this program. Thank you all for coming tonight, and I hope you have enjoyed this evening's performance, and I hope you enjoy our last piece.
Thank you. this work? Okay. So as you may have figured out, it is Robbie's last concert with us that he is in conducting it, I think.
Yeah.
Anyways, on behalf of all three choirs at Binghamton, I want to extend our deepest gratefulness, thankfulness. You've been with us for 2 years now, and you will be so dearly missed. We thank you for your time, for being a great mentor and a great friend, and we can't wait to see what you do in the future.